PK, along with Dr. Nathan Unruh, we want to just take a moment to ask you the question, how do you start your day? Okay, this is a big deal.
Big deal. And for years, I didn't get it. And I was doing things I thought were turning the dial, things that were actually making the difference, such as how many emails can I click off in the morning, or how many texts can I send out, or, you know, the laundry list of stuff we do.
Well, yeah, get that. So no number shows up on the bottom of your phone. They're all gone. Yeah. That's my goal every day.
Yeah.
Well, then I forget half of them.
Yeah. No, so true. I've developed a routine, and it allows me to be my best every day. And I ask you this, PK, what do you think is the most important time of your day?
Well, I love when I first get up. It seems like I have a lot of clarity, and if I don't write things down, I don't remember them later.
Absolutely. I agree with you 100%. Mm-hmm. The most important time of my day is my first 30 minutes. It's critical. Why? That first half hour of my day gives me the opportunity to check my attitude and determine where is my perspective. And what I do is I don't turn any media on. I don't develop the old electronic hypnosis. I want to sit quietly and be first and foremost in a state of gratitude. It's the time I start off, I do my devotions. And then after my devotions, I go through my Gladius, which is my 90-day plan. Once I've been through my Gladius, I go through my day starting at 6 a.m. until I go to bed and plan my day. What am I going to do that day? That first 30 minutes is magical.
And do you hold that pretty much sacred? Like, your family knows that you're not interruptible during that time. You don't handle anything else during that time.
Absolutely.
Is that hard to do?
It is. For me, I have my little spot that I go to. And are there those times where I say, leave me alone? Now, the good news is, if I get my loving rear end out of bed early enough, it's the old adage, be selfish at 5 a.m. Mm-hmm. So by 6 a.m., I want to have this time complete. I want to be able to spend that time before I get into the grind, the whirlwind of my day. And it has made such a huge difference. So really, from a tactical standpoint, here's what I try to accomplish in the first 30 minutes. Again, read my daily devotional. This is the time to be alone with God. It's the time where I just get my perspective and also my strength. Mm-hmm. I then, again, review all my 90-day commitments, track my progress. Then I plan out my day and write everything down from 6 a.m. until I go to bed. I plan every minute and every hour. If you want to get things done, fill up your calendar that way. Mm-hmm. And now you're intentional about what you're doing. Some people will go, why are you agitated at times? I said, I planned my day, you know, and so.
And that wasn't part of your plan.
Something it wasn't part up. Of my plan. And so sometimes I got to get, you allow yourself some grace. So some of you are probably thinking this right now and go, my gosh, dude, you're psycho. But at the same time, if you want to get things accomplished, you've got to plan. And I would say this, plan the time to exercise, plan the time just to be, hang with the kids, relax. You got to plan that too. So I always find a quote too that just connects with me for that day. And I write that down. And then I write my goals. I write my goals in the beginning of the day, and then I also write them at the end of the day. And I figure if I'm doing that 365 days a year, I got a much better chance of accomplishing what I want to get accomplished.
Goals for the day or goals overall?
Both.
Both, okay.
Both. So I found over the years, when I'm at my best, and I got to be authentic, do I get it done every single day? No, but I do 90% of the time. Mm-hmm. There's 10% of the time I just don't get it done. But I found over the years that I'm at my very best when I start my day in the following fashion, just like we talked about. I love Zig Ziglar, and he once said, we all need a checkup from the neck up. The first 30 minutes of my day is the checkup from my neck up. So I use those first 30 minutes in my day to do exactly that. As you listen to this, I don't want you to do what I do. What I want you to hear in this conversation is develop a routine and make the routine your reward. Be intentional about your life, about your goals, about what you want to see manifested. Develop a routine and make it a reward. You will be phenomenal.